Amstrad CPC. The Amstrad CPC, short for Color Personal Computer, is a series of 8-bit home computers produced by Amstrad between 1984 and 1990. It was designed to compete in the mid-1980s home computer market dominated by the Commodore 64 and the Sinclair ZX Spectrum, where it successfully established itself primarily in the United Kingdom, France, Spain, and the German-speaking parts of Europe. The series spawned a total of 6 distinct models: the CPC 464, CPC 664, and CPC 6128 were highly successful competitors in the European home computer market. The later Plus models, 464 Plus and 6128 Plus, efforts to prolong the system's lifecycle with hardware updates, were considerably less successful, as was the attempt to repackage the Plus hardware into a game console as the GX 4000. The CPC model's hardware is based on the Zilog Z80A CPU, complemented with either 64 or 128 kilobytes of RAM. Their computer in a keyboard design prominently features an integrated storage device, either a compact cassette deck or 3-inch floppy disk drive. The main units were only sold bundled with either a color, green screen or monochrome monitor that doubles as the main unit's power supply. Additionally, a wide range of first- and third-party hardware extensions such as external disk drives, printers, and memory extensions, was available. The CPC series was pitched against other home computers primarily used to play video games and enjoyed a strong supply of game software. The comparatively low price for a complete computer system with dedicated monitor, its high-resolution monochrome text and graphic capabilities and the possibility to run CP/M software also rendered the system attractive for business users, which was reflected by a wide selection of application software. During its lifetime, the CPC series sold approximately 3 million units. The philosophy behind the CPC series was twofold. Firstly, the concept was of an all-in-one, where the computer, keyboard and its data storage device were combined in a single unit, and sold with its own dedicated display monitor. Most home computers at that time, such as Sinclair ZX series, the Commodore 64 and the BBC Micro, relied on the use of the domestic television set and a separately connected tape recorder or disk drive. In itself, the all-in-one concept was not new, having been seen before on business-oriented machines and the Commodore PET, but in the home computer space, it predated the Apple Macintosh by almost a year. Secondly, Amstrad founder Alan Sugar wanted the machine to resemble a real computer, similar to what someone would see being used to check them in at the airport for their holidays, and for the machine to not look like a pregnant calculator, in reference presumably to the Sinclair ZX81 and ZX Spectrum with their low-cost, membrane-type keyboards. The CPC 464 was one of the most successful computers in Europe and sold more than 2 million units. The CPC 464 featured 64 kilobytes RAM and an internal cassette tape deck. It was introduced in June 1984 in the UK. Initial suggested retail prices for the CPC 464 were £249.00DM 899.00 with a green screen and £359.00DM 1398.00 with a color monitor. Following the introduction of the CPC 6128 in late 1985, suggested retail prices for the CPC 464 were cut by £50.00DM 100.00. In 1990, the 464 Plus replaced the CPC 464 in the model lineup, and production of the CPC 464 was discontinued. The CPC 664 features 64 kilobytes RAM and an internal 3-inch floppy disk drive. It was introduced in May 1985 in the UK. Initial suggested retail prices for the CPC 664 were £339.00DM 1198.00 with a green screen and £449.00DM 1998.00 with a color monitor. After the successful release of the CPC 464, consumers were constantly asking for two improvements: more memory and an internal disk drive. For Amstrad, the latter was easier to realize. At the deliberately low-key introduction of the CPC 664 in May 1985, the machine was positioned not only as the lowest-cost disk system but even the lowest-cost CP/M 2.2 machine. In the Amstrad CPC product range, the CPC 664 complemented the CPC 464, which was neither discontinued nor reduced in price. Compared to the CPC 464, the CPC 664's main unit has been significantly redesigned, not only to accommodate the floppy disk drive but also with a redesign of keyboard area. Touted as ergonomic by Amstrad's promotional material, the keyboard is noticeably tilted to the front with MSX-style cursor keys above the numeric keypad. Compared to the CPC 464's multicolored keyboard, the CPC 664's keys are kept in a much quieter gray and pale blue color scheme. The back of the CPC 664 main unit features the same connectors as the CPC 464, with the exception of an additional 12 volts power lead. Unlike the CPC 464's cassette tape drive that could be powered off the main unit's 5 volts voltage, the CPC 664's floppy disk drive requires an additional 12 volts voltage. This voltage had to be separately supplied by an updated version of the bundled green screen slash color monitor, GT65 and CTM644 respectively. The CPC 664 was only produced for approximately 6 months. In late 1985, when the CPC 6128 was introduced in Europe, Amstrad decided not to keep 3 models in the lineup, and production of the CPC 664 was discontinued. The CPC 6128 features 128 KB RAM and an internal 3-inch floppy disk drive. Aside from various hardware and firmware improvements, one of the CPC 6128's most prominent features is the compatibility with the CP/M+ operating system that rendered it attractive for business uses. The CPC 6128 was released in August 1985 and initially only sold in the U.S. Imported and distributed by Indiscomp Incorporated of Chicago, it was the first Amstrad product to be sold in the United States, a market that at the time was traditionally hostile towards European computer manufacturers. By the end of 1985, it arrived in Europe and replaced the CPC 664 in the CPC model lineup. Initial suggested retail prices for the CPC 6128 were $699.00/£299.00/DM1598.00 with a green screen and used $799.00/£399.00/DM2098.00 with a color monitor. In 1990, the 6128 Plus replaced the CPC 6128 in the model lineup, and production of the CPC 6128 was discontinued. In 1990, confronted with a changing home computer market, Amstrad decided to refresh the CPC model range by introducing a new range variantly labeled Plus or Plus, 1990, or CPC Plus range. The main goals were numerous enhancements to the existing CPC hardware platform, to restyle the casework to provide a contemporary appearance, and to add native support of cartridge media. The new model palette includes 3 variants, the 464 Plus and 6128 Plus computers and the GX4000 video game console. The CPC abbreviation was dropped from the model names. The redesign significantly enhanced the CPC hardware, mainly to rectify its previous shortcomings as a gaming platform. The redesigned video hardware allows for hardware sprites and soft scrolling, with a color palette extended from a maximum of 16 colors, plus separate light definable border, at one time from a choice of 27, increased to a maximum of 32 out of 4,096. The enhanced sound hardware offers automatic DMA transfer, allowing more complex sound effects with a significantly reduced processor overhead. Other hardware enhancements include the support of analog joysticks, 8-bit printers, and ROM cartridges up to 4 megabits. The new range of models was intended to be completely backward compatible with the original CPC models. Its enhanced features are only available if a deliberately obscure unlocking mechanism has been triggered, thus preventing existing CPC software from accidentally invoking them. Despite the significant hardware enhancements, many viewed it as outdated, being based on an 8-bit CPU, and it failed to attract both customers and software reproducers who were moving towards 16-bit systems such as the Commodore Amiga and Sega Mega Drive, which was launched a few short months after the Plus range. The Plus range was a commercial failure, and production was discontinued shortly after its introduction in 1990. The 464 Plus and 6128 Plus models were intended as more sophisticated and stylish replacements of the CPC 464 and CPC 6128. Based on the redesigned Plus hardware platform, they share the same base characteristics as their predecessors, The 464 Plus is equipped with 64 KB RAM on a cassette tape drive. The 6128 Plus features 128 KB RAM and a 3-inch floppy disk drive. Both models share a common case layout with a keyboard taken over from the CPC 6128 model, and the respective mass storage drive inserted in a case breakout. In order to simplify the EMC screening process, the edge connectors of the previous models have been replaced with micro-ribbon connectors as previously used on the German Schneider CPC 6128. As a result, a wide range of extensions for the original CPC range are connector incompatible with the 464 Plus and 6128 Plus. In addition, the 6128 Plus does not have a tape socket for an external tape drive. The Plus range is not equipped with an onboard ROM, and thus the 464 Plus and the 6128 Plus do not contain a firmware. Instead, Amstrad provided the firmware for both models via the ROM extension facility, contained on the included burn-in rubber and locomotive basic cartridge. This resulted in reduced hardware localization cost. Only some select keycaps and case labels had to be localized, with the added benefit of a rudimentary copy protection mechanism. Without the firmware present, the machine itself could not copy a game cartridge's content. As the enhanced B4 firmware's structural differences causes problems with some CPC software directly calling firmware functions by their memory addresses, Amstrad separately sold the cartridge containing the original CPC 6128's V3 firmware. Both the 464 Plus and the 6128 Plus were introduced to the public in September 1990. Initial suggested retail prices were 1,990 French francs with a green screen and FRF 2990 with a color monitor for the 464 Plus, and 2,990 French francs with a green screen and 3,990 French francs with a color monitor for the 6128 Plus. Developed as part of the Plus range, the GX4000 was Amstrad's short-lived attempt to enter the video game consoles market. Sharing the Plus range's enhanced hardware characteristics, it represents the bare minimum variant of the range without a keyboard or support for mass storage devices. It came bundled with two paddle controllers and the racing game Burning Rubber. In 1985, Spain briefly introduced an import tax on computers without N-letter key and containing 64 KB or less of RAM. To circumvent this, Amstrad Spanish distributor Indiscomp, later to become Amstrad Spain, created and distributed the CPC 472, a modified version of the CPC 464. Its main difference is a small additional daughter board containing a CPC 664 ROM chip, and an 8 KB memory chip which is not electrically connected to the machine, and consequently rendered unusable. Its sole purpose was supposedly to increase the machine's total memory specs to 72 KB in order to circumvent the import tax. Only a month after the CPC 472 had been released, Amstrad added the N-tilde key for the 464, so this tariff was not applied to 64K computers anymore and production of the CPC 472 was discontinued. The, which means small computer, being a rather literal German translation of the English microcomputer, is a clone of the Amstrad CPC built by East Germany's in October 1989. Although the machine included various substitutes and emulations of an Amstrad CPC's hardware, the machine is largely compatible with Amstrad CPC software. It is equipped with 64 KB memory and a CPC 6128's firmware customized to the modified hardware, including an unmodified copy of Locomotive Basic 1.1. The KC Compact is the last 8-bit computer produced in East Germany. In 1993, Omsk, Russia-based company Panasonic released the Alest520X, a computer highly compatible with the Amstrad CPC 6128. It could also be switched into an MSX mode. An expansion board named Magic Sound allowed to play Scream Tracker files. A Byte columnist in January 1985 called the CPC 464 the closest yet to filling his criteria for a useful home computer, including good keyboard, 80-column text, inexpensive disk drive, and support for a mainstream operating system like CP/M. The entire CPC series is based on the Zilog Z80A processor, clocked at 4 MHz. In order to avoid conflicts resulting from the CPU and the video circuits both accessing the shared main memory, snowing, CPU memory access is constrained to occur on microsecond boundaries, effectively padding every CPU instruction to a multiple of 4 CPU cycles. As typical Z80 instructions require 3 or 4 CPU cycles, the resulting loss of processing power is minor, reducing the effective clock rate to approximately 3.3 MHz. Amstrad CPCs are equipped with Ether 64, CPC 464, CPC 664, 464 Plus, GX 4000, or 128, CPC 6128, 6128 Plus, KB of RAM. This base memory can be extended by up to 512 KB using memory expansions sold by third-party manufacturers, and by up to 4096 KB using experimental methods developed by hardware enthusiasts. Because the Z80 processor is only able to directly address 64 kilobytes of memory, additional memory from the 128th models and memory expansions is made available using bank switching. Underlying a CPC's video output is the unusual pairing of a CRTC, Motorola 6845 or compatible, with a custom-designed gateway to generate a pixel display output. CPC 6128S later in production as well as the models from the Plus range integrate both the CRTC and the gateway's functions with the system's ASIC. Three built-in display resolutions are available, 160x200 pixels with 16 colors, mode 0, 20 text columns, 320x200 pixels with 4 colors, mode 1, 40 text columns, and 640x200 pixels with 2 colors, mode 2, 80 text columns. Increased screen size can be achieved by reprogramming the CRTC. The original CPC video hardware supports a color palette of 27 colors, generated from RGB color space with each color component assigned as either off, half on, or on. The Plus range extended the palette to 4096 colors, also generated from RGB with 4 bits each for red, green and blue. With the exception of the GX4000, all CPC models lack an RF television or composite video output and instead shipped with a 6-pin RGB DIN connector, also used by Acorn Computers, to connect the supplied Amstrad monitor. This connector delivers a 1VPP analog RGB with a 50Hz composite sync signaled hat, if wired correctly, can drive a 50Hz SCART television. External adapters for RF television were available as a first-party hardware accessory. The CPC uses the General Instrument AY38912 sound chip, providing 3 channels, each configurable to generate square waves, white noise or both. A small array of hardware volume envelopes are available. Output is provided in mono by a small, 4 cm, built-in loudspeaker with volume control, driven by an internal amplifier. Stereo output is provided through a headphones jack. It is possible to play back digital sound samples at a resolution of approximately 5-bit by sending a stream of values to the sound chip. This technique is very processor intensive and hard to combine with any other processing. Examples are the title screens or other non-playable scenes of games like Chase HQ, Meltdown, and RoboCop. The later Plus models incorporated a DMA engine in order to offload this processing. Amstrad used Hitachi's 3-inch floppy disk drive. The chosen drive, built in for later models, is a single-sided 40-track unit that requires the user to physically remove and flip the disk to access the other side. Each side has its own independent write protect switch. The sides are termed A and B, with each one commonly formatted to 180 kilobytes, in AMSDO's format, comprising 2 kilobytes directory and 178 kilobytes storage, for a total of 360 kilobytes per disk. The interface with the drives is a NEC 765FDC, used for the same purpose in the IBM PC/XT, PC/ED and PS/2 machines. Its features are not fully used in order to cut costs, namely DMA transfers and support for single-density disks. They were formatted as double-density uses modified frequency modulation. Disks were shipped in a paper sleeve or a hard plastic case resembling a compact disk jewel case. The casing is thicker and more rigid than that of 3.5-inch diskettes, and designed to be mailed without any additional packaging. A sliding metal cover to protect the media surface is internal to the casing and latched, unlike the simple external sliding cover of Sony's version. They were significantly more expensive than both 5.25-inch and 3.5-inch alternatives. This, combined with their low nominal capacities and their essentially proprietary nature, led to the format being discontinued shortly after the CPC itself was discontinued. Apart from Amstrad's other 3-inch machines, the PCW and the ZX Spectrum Plus 3, the few other computer systems to use them included the Sega SF7000 and CP/M systems such as the Tatung Einstein and Osborne machines. They also found use on embedded systems. The Shugart standard interface means that Amstrad CPC machines are able to use standard 3 inches, 3.5 inches or 5 and 1/4 inches drives as their second drive. Programs such as ROMDOS and PARADOS extend the standard AMSTOS system to provide support for double-sided, 80-track formats, enabling up to 800 KB to be stored on a single disk. The 3-inch disks themselves are usually known as disks on the CPC, following the spelling on the machine's plastic casing and conventional British English spelling. The hardware and firmware was designed to be able to access software provided on external ROMs. Each ROM has to be a 16 kilobytes block and is switched in and out of the memory space shared with the video RAM. The Amstrad firmware is deliberately designed so that new software could be easily accessed from these ROMs with a minimum of fuss. Popular applications were marketed on ROM, particularly word processing and programming utility software. Examples are ProText and Brunword of the former, and the Maxim assembler of the latter type. Such extra ROM chips do not plug directly into the CPC itself, but into extra plug-in ROM boxes which contain sockets for the ROM chips and a minimal amount of decoding circuitry for the main machine to be able to switch between them. These boxes were either marketed commercially or could be built by competent hobbyists, and they attach to the main expansion port at the back of the machine. Software on ROM loads much faster than from disk or tape, and the machine's boot up sequence was designed to evaluate ROMs it found and optionally hand over control of the machine to them. This allows significant customization of the functionality of the machine, something that enthusiasts exploited for various purposes. However, the typical users would probably not be aware of this added ROM functionality unless they read the CPC press, as it is not described in the user manual and was hardly ever mentioned in marketing literature. It is, however, documented in the official Amstrad firmware manual. The machines also feature a 9-pin Atari joystick port that will either directly take one joystick, or two joysticks by use of a splitter cable. Amstrad issued two RS-232CD25 serial interfaces, attached to the expansion connector on the rear of the machine, with a through connector for the CPC-464 disk drive or other peripherals. The original interface came with a book of spells for facilitating data transfer between other systems using a proprietary protocol on the device's own ROM, as well as terminal software to connect to British Telecom's Prestel service. A separate version of the ROM was created for the US market due to the use of the commands vertical bar suck and vertical bar blow, which were considered unacceptable there. Software and hardware limitations in this interface led to its replacement with an Amstrad-branded version of a compatible alternative by PACE. Serial interfaces were also available from third-party vendors such as KDS Electronics and Circuit. Like most home computers at the time, the CPC has its OS and a basic interpreter built in as ROM. It uses Locomotive Basic, an improved version of Locomotive Software's C80 Basic for the BBC microcomputer coprocessor board. It is particularly notable for providing easy access to the machine's video and audio resources in contrast to the poke commands required on generic Microsoft implementations. Other unusual features include timed event handling with the after and every commands, and text-based windowing. Digital Research's CP/M operating system was supplied with the 664 and 6128 disk-based systems, and the DDI1 disk expansion unit for the 464.64K machines shipped with CP/M 2.2 alone, while the 128K machines also include CP/M 3.1. The compact CP/M 2.2 implementation is largely stored on the boot sectors of a 3-inch disk in what was called system format. Typing vertical bar CPM from Locomotive Basic would load code from these sectors, making it a popular choice for custom game loading routines. The CP/M 3.1 implementation is largely in a separate file which is in turn loaded from the boot sector. Much public domain CP/M software was made available for the CPC, from word processors such as VDE to complete bulletin board systems such as ROS. Although it was possible to obtain compilers for Locomotive Basic, C and Pascal, the majority of the CPC's software was written in native Z80 assembly language. Popular assemblers were Hisoft's DivPak, Arnor's Maxim, and, in France, DAMS. Disk-based CPC, not Plus, Systems shipped with an interpreter for the educational language logo, booted from CP/M2.2 but largely CPC-specific with much code resident in the AMSDOS ROM, 6128 machines also include a CP/M3.1, non-ROM version. AC compiler was also written and made available for the European market through Tandy Europe, by Micro Business Products. In an attempt to give the CPC a recognizable mascot, a number of games by Amstrad's in-house software publisher Amsoft have been tagged with the Roland name. However, as the games had not been designed around the Roland character and only had the branding added later, the character design varies immensely, from a spiky-haired blonde teenager, Roland goes digging, to a white cube with legs, Roland goes square bashing, or a mutant flea, Roland in the caves. The only two games with similar gameplay and main character design are Roland in Time and its sequel Roland in Space. The Roland character was named after Roland Perry, one of the lead designers of the original CPC range. In order to market its computers in Germany, Austria, and Switzerland where Amstrad did not have any distribution structures, Amstrad entered a partnership with Schneider Rundfunk-Orca AG, a German company that, very much like Amstrad itself, was previously only known for value-priced audio products. In 1984, Schneider Computer Division daughter company was created specifically for the task, and the complete Amstrad CPC lineup was branded and sold as Schneider CPC. Although they are based on the same hardware, the Schneider CPC models differ from the Amstrad CPC models in several details. Most prominently, the Schneider CPC-464 and CPC-664 keyboards featured gray instead of colored keys, but still in the original British keyboard layout. To achieve a German Gewurz keyboard layout, Schneider marketed a small software program to reassign the keys as well as sticker labels for the keys. In order to conform with stricter German EMC regulations, the complete Schneider CPC lineup is equipped with an internal metal shielding. For the same reason, the Schneider CPC-6128 features micro-ribbon type connectors instead of edge connectors. Both the grayscale keyboard and the micro-ribbon connectors found their way up into the design of later Amstrad CPC models. In 1988, after Schneider refused to market Amstrad's a compatible computer line, the cooperation ended. Schneider went on to sell the remaining stock of Schneider CPC models and used their now well-established market position to introduce its own PC designs. With the formation of its German daughter company Amstrad GmbH to distribute its product lines including the CPC-464 and CPC-6128, Amstrad attempted but ultimately failed to establish their own brand in German-speaking parts of Europe. The Amstrad CPC enjoyed a strong and long lifetime, mainly due to the machines used for businesses as well as gaming. Dedicated programmers continued working on the CPC range, even producing graphical user interface, GUI, operating systems such as SimpOS. Internet sites devoted to the CPC have appeared from around the world featuring forums, news, hardware, software, programming and games. CPC magazines appeared during the 1980s including publications in countries such as Britain, France, Spain, Germany, Denmark, Australia, and Greece. Titles included the official Amstrad Computer User publication, as well as independent titles like Amstrad Action, Amdex, Computing with the Amstrad CPC, CPC Attack, Australia's The Amstrad User, France's Amstrad CentPort Cent and Amstar. Following the CPC's end of production, Amstrad gave permission for the CPC ROMs to be distributed freely as long as the copyright message is not changed and that it is acknowledged that Amstrad still holds copyright, giving emulator authors the possibility to ship the CPC firmware with their programs. Amstrad followed their success with the CPC-464 by launching the Amstrad PCW word processor range, another Z80 base machine with a 3-inch disk drive and software by Locomotive Software. The PCW was originally developed to be partly compatible with an improved version of the CPC, ANT, or Arnold No. 2. The CPC's development code name was Arnold. However, Amstrad decided to focus on the PCW, and the ANT project never came to market. On April 7, 1986, Amstrad announced it had bought from Sinclair Research the worldwide rights to sell and manufacture all existing and future Sinclair computers and computer products, together with the Sinclair brand name and those intellectual property rights where they relate to computers and computer-related products, which included the ZX Spectrum, for £5 million. This included Sinclair's unsold stock of Sinclair QLs and Spectrums. Amstrad made more than £5 million on selling these surplus machines alone. Amstrad launched two new variants of the Spectrum, the ZX Spectrum Plus 2, based on the ZX Spectrum 128, with a built-in tape drive, like the CPC 464, and, the following year, the ZX Spectrum Plus 3, with a built-in floppy disk drive, similar to the CPC 664 and 6128, taking the 3-inch disks that Amstrad CPC machines use. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.